If you were able to get passes on hashtag Open Reg Day for San Diego Comic-Con, I have one thing to say to you.
Boo frickity who! I had the best grades in the class and I didn't get diddly squat!
Hello and welcome to the Pop Culture Cult. I'm Sean.
I'm Janice.
And this is episode 21.
21, we're legal.
We're legal. We should have brought drinks.
We should have.
Totally. Yeah, this is what happens when you plan on the fly. Ton of stuff has happened in the last week. I've been kind of complaining the last couple of weeks about how there's been nothing going on, and now we got, like, I cut a bunch of stuff out of this because we just not going to be able to get to it. New trailers came out, like, I'm not kidding, like, an hour ago. We had a whole long conversation. Shit's going to go down. We want to got some stuff that we want to go over, but the one thing that I wanted to mention first off is, as of today at about noon, we crossed 100 followers on Facebook. Yay! Now if we can just get that to like quadruple and kajillion it and then add it to YouTube, we'll get there. We're getting there. Baby steps.
All
baby
those
steps.
People who are following us on Facebook, now go subscribe on YouTube.
Yes. It's only a quarter. There's only a quarter of the people on Facebook are following us on YouTube. So, let's go, people. All right, let's start off with the trailer reaction for Ragnarok.
It's not the movie I thought it was going to be.
No. is it Guardians of the Galaxy does Ragnarok?
Well, yeah. I mean, it's very unlike any other Thor movie.
Yeah.
Yes, Guardians of the Galaxy... Stranger Things, 70s.
In the 70s font. Yeah. Okay, it's a teaser. It's a super teaser trailer. It's kind of just showing you that Thor's in trouble and that they're at the Guardian facility with the Incredible, and then he busts Incredible Hulk. And they're introducing the Hulk. Here comes the Incredible! And he busts through the door. It's like, just say it! And then Thor, yes, we're friends from work. Hela looks amazing. Kate Blanchett as Hela looks awesome. The Valkyries are in it for like all of 2 seconds. I had some funny feelings in my pantry reason when Kate Blanchett walked out. Just sorry.
You're that way about Kate Blanchett anyway.
Well, that's true. Just wow. Got my attention. Probably one of the better trailers we had this year. So, Guardians has been really good. The Mummy was really awesome. So there's been some really good trailers. Now, here's the thing. Live up to those fucking trailers.
Yes.
Don't pull a DC and have awesome trailers and then we go home at the end of the night going, what the fuck was that?
Well, it's Marvel, so I don't think they will.
No. And there's all kinds of, like, fan theories about stuff that's going to happen and just... Let's get the Guardians. We'll get it, all right? All right. So Walking Dead is done for the season.
Yep.
And we have some spoilers. Spoilers. We'll get into that in a minute. So our correspondent for Walking Dead, Janice. Because zombies and bad and nightmares and... There might be whiskey sometimes involved. So, do us a quick rundown of what the season was like.
Okay. I made notes so I would remember, because if you watch Walking Dead, you know that they show half of the show in the fall, and then they break for like 2 months or whatever, and then they show the second half kind of in the spring. So, I had to take some notes so I remembered everything that happened. So... I'll go over some of the stuff and then I'll kind of do my wrap up. So the very first episode you did watch.
I watched that one.
Everybody wanted to know
what happened.
Who Negan killed.
Yeah.
So again, spoilers. So it was Abraham and Glenn, right? So.
And Glenn was the one that nobody really expected to happen because it was the second one. I'm just keep talking.
Oh, okay. All right. Yes.
When I take this down, we'll be done talking about Walking Dead.
Okay. Negan takes Daryl, kidnaps him, whatever, takes him hostage, takes him back with the Saviors, and there's a lot of him kind of working on Rick, trying to break him down, because he understands Rick is the leader, you know, and he's got to break him down to get the rest to follow along. Carol and Morgan in the previous season had left. They didn't like the direction that that Alexandria or the group that was being led by Rick was going. A lot of killing of people, not zombie people.
Right.
So they didn't like that. They ended up at the kingdom, and that's where Ezekiel and his tiger are introduced to the story, along with everybody else in the kingdom.
Which the shot that I saw floating around when that episode happened was Ezekiel sitting there with the tiger, and it's like they took it right out of the comic. It's the same shot from the comic, which was awesome.
Yeah, yeah. So there's several episodes of again Negan breaking Rick down. He shows up at Alexandria before his scheduled time. They take everything. I think they leave him some mattresses. Maybe they take like most of their food, their guns, everything. And Rosita finds a shell casing in the woods. So now they have no guns, no ammo, nothing. She finds a shell casing in the woods and asks Eugene to make her a bullet. That becomes important many episodes later.
Later.
So Carl sneaks out. He jumps in a truck. Jesus actually jumps into the same truck later at another stop, and they're all going back to the Saviors. Carl ends up getting caught, but Negan, instead of killing him or capturing him or whatever, thinks the kid has spunk. Maybe is trying to get under Rick's skin. I don't know. But he shows him around and then takes him back to Alexandria, where he proceeds to make himself at home and in Rick's home. And the end of that episode is a pretty epic shot of Negan makes dinner. They're all waiting for Rick to come home. So Negan is sitting at the head of the table, kind of the dad. Carl is to the side, the son. Olivia, who is the nurse at Alexandria, is sitting at the side, and she is with Rick's baby. I can't remember her name.
Baby.
And so it's this very dysfunctional family.
That was the end of the mid-season finale, wasn't it?
No. It was I think it was this end of that episode, maybe, but no, because then Negan goes out and starts playing pool in the middle of the street, as one does, and Spencer, who there's a bunch of backstory to him, but he's kind of this, Rick took my town away from me and Alexandria should be mine, and kind of goes to Negan, and he's like, you know, hey, let's join up and we can get rid of Rick. And Negan says, you know, you're a weasel, and kills him. Then Sasha gets, this is all like happening just back to back to back. This is why I made notes. Rosita has the bullet that Eugene made, shoots at Negan after he kills Spencer, misses Negan, hits Lucille, the baseball bat. That pisses Negan off, and he says, now somebody's gonna die, and he points at this chick on his side, one of the Saviors, and says, you gotta kill somebody, and she just points her gun and shoots Olivia right in the head. Very reminiscent of the previous doctor, and I can't remember her name, anyway, getting shot through the eyeball with the arrow. I think that was Dwight that shot her in the previous season. So then Olivia gets killed, and they take Eugene at hostage back to the Savior's camp. So that is pretty much the catalyst. Rick comes back, you know, he comes home from scavenging guns or whatever for Negan. He finds all his people dead and Eugene's gone, and now he's pissed off. So he takes everybody and they go to Hilltop. Jesus, when Jesus was at the Savior's, when him and Carl jumped on the truck, Jesus found what's his name?
Daryl,
thank you. Where's his name in here? Finds Daryl and brings him back to the Hilltop. So Rick and the gang don't know that Daryl's out. They all go to the Hilltop. They're like, okay, Rick's like, we're gonna get everybody, we're gonna take this guy on. And they get there, Daryl's there, there's a big reunion, Daryl's got Rick's gun, now Rick's gonna go kick ass and take names. That's the end of the first half.
Jiminy criminy.
Right. So the second half goes a lot faster because it's really just a lot of character development or group development, right? So you start, you learn who the scavengers are, you learn who Oceanside is, you kind of learn more about the kingdom. There's more people, you know, dying and kind of the alignment. No, we're not going to go. And then something happens. Okay, yeah, we're going to go. And all of this leading up to kind of the end. Sasha and Rosita sneak into the Saviors to bring Eugene home. But Eugene has decided that he likes it there. He's kind of a getting along to get along kind of guy. So he doesn't want to go. And Sasha ends up getting kidnapped by the Saviors, and Rosita makes it out. She runs into Dwight on the way. So Dwight has been on the Savior side. He's been,
right.
But Negan doesn't treat him very well. So even though he's like his right-hand man, he treats him like shit. And then you don't see him again for a little while. But basically what ends up happening is Dwight ends up in Alexandria saying, I'm going to help you guys. Sasha gets kidnapped. She's now in the Saviors. She ends up basically, you know, they're like, okay, Negan's going to take her to Alexandria and he's going to prove a point. And she asks Eugene for a knife or a gun or something because she makes it sound like she's going to off herself. What he brings her is this pill that he had made for one of Negan's wives. And it's basically like a cyanide capsule or whatever. And she's like, you know, shit, this isn't what I wanted. So then she ends up in this casket. Negan's going to make this point. They all go to Alexandria. Negan's, you know, standing up there and he's like, I know you guys have been rallying and trying to get behind me. Rick's got the scavengers that are apparently on Rick's side, Alexandria's side. Negan says, well, I have something for you. And he opens up the casket with Sasha. Except on the ride, Sasha has taken that cyanide pill, and so now she's a zombie. And so she goes after Negan. She ends up biting the guy standing next to him. Negan's like, whoa! And then the scavengers turn on Rick's group. So there's a lot of shooting and drama and everything, and it comes to a lot of the Alexandria people are, you know, dead. And or are captured, and Negan needs to make a point, and it kind of ends the same way it started. Negan was going to cut off Carl's arm in the very first episode of this season to get Rick to understand that he needs to, you know, get with the program. And now we're kind of full circle, and he's about ready to bash Carl's head in with Lucille, and the tiger jumps. So now the kingdom's here. The tiger jumps and attacks one of his guys, and they're shooting.
That's also straight out of the comic, that scene, yeah.
Yeah, and so Negan's group ends up, you know, leaving, you know, this isn't the end. Da, da, da. And that's pretty much the end of the season. So Negan's pissed off, but wounded. I mean, his group is wounded by what these guys have done, and if they can, I mean, right now it's just Hilltop, Alexandria, and the kingdom. They haven't gotten Oceanside yet, and the scavengers, you know, took Negan's side, so I don't know what's going to go on with that. So lots of kind of character building. And so I can see if I haven't really read a lot of reviews or anything, but I can see where people might have felt like it was slow. And there were parts that were slow. There were whole episodes where it was just character building, or, you know, kind of the somebody gets killed in some group that meant a lot to those people, and that is right. kind of the catalyst that makes them want to join Rick's group. And so there was a lot of that, but I think that the payoff in the final episode was
more of a slow burn, trying to build, like you can't, with a show like this, you can't have, like, it's boom, and then boom, like, every episode where it's, like, right. crazy. You have to have some character development, especially when it's, like, what, 20 or 22 episodes or something like that?
I think it's 16.
16, okay. Yeah. So, but you're still, in 16 episodes, you still have to do some character development, or you're not going to care about the characters when something happens to them.
Right. Well, and so. I was wondering, too, because I didn't think that they would kill Negan off this season.
Mm-mm.
You know, because my understanding is he's, he is the big bad of the whole comics book series, right. so I would expect him to be around.
They I read something that he's supposed to be around for 4 or 5 seasons. They want to do another 4 or 5 seasons, so
okay. I don't know.
It's the number one rated show on cable, so it's hard to say no to it, right? So if everybody wants to keep doing it, and the network's gonna, and they're still getting ratings, then. Go you guys. So yep. Worth it. Worth the season.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
So everybody on the internet can shut up. Calm down.
Like I said, I haven't read the reviews. I thought it was one of the better seasons. Like I said, there was just some slow parts because it was, you know, you
trying to get to a point.
Yeah, yeah. You can't just have all these groups just, oh yeah, we'll come with you and we'll go after Negan. That's not how it's going to be.
Right. Right. Okay. All right. There you go. A full season review of Walking Dead. I'm sure at San Diego Comic-Con they'll have a whole bunch more stuff. Maybe not the same kind of level they did last year, but we should be interested to see kind of what the trailer will be like and everything.
Yeah,
they'll have
yeah.
a big thing then. That'll be June, so it'll be about right and stuff. So,
yep.
All right, that'll be interesting. All right, so a few more things that we wanted to cover today. Star Wars Celebration starts in a day and a half. And this morning they had a huge announcement. It was all over the internet. There's this huge celebration announcement. And Mark Hamill and Daisy Ripley are going to be on Good Morning America. So you know it's a big deal when they're on Good Morning America. And so they plastered all over the internet. And then this morning it was a trailer for Force for Change. Now, I'm wearing my I Rebel shirt. I spent money to go to UNICEF. She's got one,
I got
too.
One too.
So I don't want to be too upset because what they do with Force for Change is awesome. It's just everybody's so ready to go with Celebration, and they make this big thing that we're going to make this big announcement on Good Morning America, and then it's this. And now I wasn't necessarily surprised. I was kind of hoping it would be like a 10-second trailer or 10-second tease of a lightsaber coming on or something, you know. But we'll get all that and by Friday anyway. So
soon.
We'll wait. The Force for Change, though, they're doing 3 winners. One of them is an overnight stay at Skywalker Ranch. They pretty much give you a free run of the place.
We have to reenact fanboys.
Well, I have to do fanboys.
Oh, totally.
I brought a grappling hook. The other one is go to the premiere in LA for The Last Jedi. You get the full red carpet treatment and go in with everybody and go to the party afterwards. Or you get a walk-on role in Han Solo.
Ooh.
Yeah. See, that was...
That's forever, though.
Oh, yeah. That's that. You'll be on screen at least one scene. It might be a bloop, but you'll be on there. They did this for The Force Awakens, too. They didn't have the other two, but they had the walk-on role. That's kind of...
See, it would depend. Are you a stormtrooper? Because nobody's ever going to know
no.
that it's
I want to be, like in Jedha, like... And Jedha's dead. But I want to be in, like, the robes for the Church of the Wills, like, a monk kind of thing. That would be kind of... That would be liking robes on, but my head exposed and stuff. That's just a thing. And I want to keep the costume because I'm going to cosplay the shit out of it. Donations start for as little as $10, and they go all the way up to $50,000. After $25, you start getting like emails of thank yous, and you get, if like $50, you get a patch, and $100, you get a shirt, and you spend $1,000, you get all the shirts, and there's just all this stuff. But at $50,000, if you donate $50,000, you get 500,000 entries, and you get a private screening of The Last Jedi in your hometown with 20 of your guests. So for $50,000, you're getting a private screening.
Huh.
And a chance to be in the Han Solo.
Well, movie. A pretty good chance, apparently.
Yeah. So, you know, if we had $50,000, I would highly consider it. Because I could probably find 20 people to do it.
Oh, absolutely.
And the other star universe, as you can tell back here, we've got Trek and Wars in the same vicinity. So remember last week when we were talking about Vic and how he does Star Trek Continues with a bunch of people, and we're like, he needs to do a new episode. So Wednesday, a new freaking episode came out. Episode 8 came out. It's called, I follow all the pages, all their Facebook pages, Twitter pages. I saw nothing. But you know how the algorithm works on Facebook. If you don't like their page every, you know, 5 seconds, it gets lost. This episode was called Still Threads the Shadow. No, Still Treads the Shadow. Sorry, there it is. This is episode 8 of Star Trek Continues. There's two Kirks. The Defiant is there. It's kind of just an interesting, really cool episode. I personally think it's probably one of the better ones they've done. It's still super cheesy, and the makeup's pretty cheesy and stuff. I was really impressed with Vic's acting, because he's playing two different Kirks.
I thought it was interesting too that spoilers kind of.
Yeah.
One of the Kirks is much older.
Yeah.
So. Playing, you know, James Tiberius Kirk, he wears the skin tight uniform.
Yeah, yeah.
And then the older Kirk was in this baggy,
yeah,
not skin tight uniform.
Yeah, yeah.
Which I thought was interesting.
It was very cool. There's a computer program, it's called Tiberius, who's kind of the antagonist. Yeah, the antagonist. In the whole thing. It's a really, really well done episode. I was really happy with it. And I would go watch Star Trek Continues. If you like sci-fi, go watch Star Trek Continues. If you like Star Trek, go watch Star Trek Continues. If you like the original series, definitely go watch it. It's so much fun. And there's 8 episodes. You can get through it in a day. They're only like 40 to 50 minutes, and they're on YouTube. And they're free.
They're free.
I love the word free. So we've been doing a lot of talking about Phoenix Comic Con. We're in that stretch of time right now where they're doing the big pushing, announcing all the guests, and they had a bunch of more authors show up and a bunch of more comic book artists that are showing, and I'm trying to keep track of everything as fast and as much as I can. I actually work for a living. I know it's strange, and I get to sit around and watch all this stuff all day like some people, like Blind Wave. I'll tell you that story after we're done.
If we had more YouTube followers, then we wouldn't have
then
to
we
work.
Could one of us could stay home, and
I get to stay home. Okay.
Some more. Somebody just started a new job on Monday, just saying. So we've been posting a bunch of stuff, and we keep talking about it on the show because it's a big deal for us. It's 15 minutes from our house. It's a big con, you know, across the country. People come from all over the country to come to this con. So we keep adding, you know, keep talking about it. So this week, with all the artists and authors and everybody who showed up, we had 5 new guest stars, guests, special guests or whatever, actors. So the first one was, I'm going to mess up this name.
Falk. Henshel?
Henshel. He plays Hawkman on Arrow and DC's Legends of Tomorrow. Hawk Girl, the girl that plays Hawk Girl. They were both in season 1, and they were in episodes of Arrow. They're going to be here together, so that's kind of interesting that they're coming together. They're not in this season, But that's fine. It's Legends of Tomorrow. They're going to change the cast all the time. We're getting Gabriel Luna, who plays the Robbie Reyes Ghost Rider on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. He's kind of still kind of new to the scene, so kind of interested to see what he has to talk about and what his panels are like. I thought that was kind of cool that he's coming. Now, here we go. Arthur Darvill, Arthur Darvill, who plays Rory on Doctor Who. He also plays Rip on Legends of Tomorrow, and he does Broadchurch. He left Legends to go film Broadchurch, and now he's back on Legends. He's going to be here, but only on Sunday, along with Charlie Cox, Murdoch from Daredevil. And then today, they announced Jenna Coleman, who's Clara, the Impossible Girl, from Doctor Who.
Clara Oswald.
And she's also doing Victoria. She left after she left Doctor Who to go to Victoria. I would not be surprised if she doesn't show back up. She's also Sunday only. Sunday's gonna suck. Yes.
We should just not even cosplay on Sunday because we're just gonna spend the day in panels.
We're just gonna you know, we'll have to get all of our shopping done on Saturday.
I'll wear my TARDIS dress, and you can wear your I don't know TARDIS socks or something.
I'll wear my the Doctor Saving Sherlock shirt or something. Yeah, I was gonna wear that tonight, but you know, we're talking about UNICEF and stuff. And then for me, I think this is awesome. Danny fucking Trejo is coming to Phoenix Comic Con. Now, he better bring a fucking taco truck.
That's what I'm saying.
There was all that stuff on 3rd, and they had all the food trucks. Freaking serving tacos, man. Come on. You got a little taco shop in L.A.? Come on. It's Danny Trejo. Do I have to explain to you all the stuff that he's been in? I'll just say Machete.
Machete. Machete kills.
There's one question.
Machete in space.
No, we're not doing Machete. Well, it's kind of Machete. There's one question and one question only. When are we getting Machete in space? It has to happen. Come on, Robert Rodriguez. Get your shit together. I know you're trying to start a TV channel and whatever, but come on. So that's about 20. I was counting it up the other day before they announced Gina. And they were at like 25 guests, like actors and stuff like that, who are there. And I was thinking they'd probably get to about 30. So they probably have a couple more to do. They have 3 days worth of panels. They have 2 rooms. You do 6 or 7 per room. That's pretty close to 30. So I posted to the Blue Ribbon Army page today that after Gina Coleman got announced, Matt Smith and David Tennant, I don't think have ever been to Phoenix for a Comic-Con.
It needs to be Matt Smith.
It needs to be Matt Smith.
Because she's his Impossible Girl.
Right. Although, David Tennant was in Jessica Jones, and we're getting a bunch of the Marvel...
That's true.
Marvel stuff, so...
That's true.
And I'm still hoping for Adam Savage and Neil deGrasse Tyson and Mark Hamill.
They need to just do a science... You could get us.
I keep asking. I sent a freaking suggestion today, and it was Matt Smith, Mark Hamill, Adam Savage, and Twisted Tunes. I'm still beating the drum for Twisted Tunes. I'm the only one beating the drum, I think, but I'll keep trying.
I'm there with you.
All right. Okay. We're the two of us.
Of course, Twisted Tunes will be on, like, in a panel when something that we really
want to
go
to. Alan Tudyk. Now, Alan should be on Twisted Tunes. Okay, we're going down a rabbit hole. it's happening, people. It's happening. So, what do you guys think? First off, I want to thank everybody who has followed us on Facebook, who has subscribed us on YouTube. Please, please, please share with your friends. Share with everybody because we like to talk to our friends about all the stupid stuff that we like. So, please share with your friends. You can find us here on YouTube. You can also find us on Facebook at the Pop Culture Cult. We're on Instagram at Pop Culture Cult 1.
Uno.
And we're also on Twitter at Pop_Cult1. And let us know, what did you think of the season of The Walking Dead? Does Ragnarok look amazing?
Yes.
And we didn't talk about the Doctor Who stuff. All right. Until next time. This is Sean.
And Janice.
For the Pop Culture Cult. Good night now. Hey, everybody. Like this video and share it with your friends. And if you point here, you subscribe to the YouTube channel. And if you point here, this is our latest video. Now my hand's in the way. This is our latest video. And until next time, good night now.